Hey, how's it going? Welcome to Rapid Fire Reaper Tutorials. All the info, none of the fluff, so let's get to it. Today, I want to talk to you about configurations. So obviously, Reaper is awesome. You can customize almost everything, set a hotkey to anything you want. You can create your own custom thumbnails. You can make your own screen sets and flip between them really quickly. So something that's really important when you get all this functionality is an ability to save them and recall them, right? You don't want to get into a situation where you have to reinstall. If your computer crashes or something, you would have to start customizing Reaper from the ground up again. And that's something you don't want. So if you go to preferences, at the very top in general, you can see import configuration and export configuration. So what I like to do every once in a while is to export all my configurations, and I'll show you what they are. So configurations are all the settings that are customizable in Reaper. So color themes, plugin presets, your effects chains, your track templates, some MISC data like your track icons and your toolbar icons, all this stuff that I downloaded off the internet, your menus and toolbars, your actions, your menu sets, your Media Explorer databases. So if you don't know what Media Explorer databases are, I explained that in my Sound Design for Visual Media series, so I'll put a link for that up there. All this info that exists in Reaper, you can save them right here. So every once in a while, I just like to do a backup. The only thing I don't backup are language packs because I don't use them. And then to save all my configurations together is under 200 megabytes. If your computer ever crashes or dies on you, you can bring it back. If you ever go to another studio or something, or go to a friend's computer, you can just immediately bring that in, and you can share this with other people. And then the same thing for when you're importing, right? If I'm trying to import my settings, it says importing configuration will require Reaper to restart. It closes Reaper. Oh, that's me. And then it allows you to say what you want to import into Reaper. And then you just say import. It would also tell you what it's about to install and modify. Really useful thing. If you have never exported your configurations, definitely do it. Upload a few versions of it to Google Drive. Share it with your friends. It makes Reaper even more versatile. I'll also later show you how to do different portable installs, but there's a video by Kenny Joya, which I will put the link up there. So that's it for today, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.